थैंक यू. आई एम एस कॉलेज गगन सर एंड द टीम ऑफ गगन सर फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी फॉर दिस वेबिनार. सर्टेनली आई विल बी वेरी हैप्पी टू शेयर माई थॉट्स एंड सर्टेन नॉलेज ऑन प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट डोमेन वेयर आई एम वर्किंग करेंटली. सो बिफोर we start, let me share my screen. Actually, I had not used this platform previously, so I'm playing a video to all of you. It's long time. I can see that all the faculties and students are listening to talks. So before starting my talk, I just want to show you a little bit and you can relax and see this video. Let me know if you are able to see the, if you are able to hear also.
Yes, sir.
Holland comes in for a pit stop.
Okay.
Time to refuel and change tires. Lou Moore himself changes the tires. Only four crew members, including the driver, are allowed to work on the car. It's a tense time. Holland stays in his seat, anxious to get away. Let's watch. Tires are changed at last. A crewman polishes the windshield as Holland moves away just 67 seconds after he stopped.
My screen is visible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
So I will try to keep this session a little bit interactive, although Gagan sir has guided me to not make it interactive, but I want to make it a little bit interactive. So you saw this video. Anybody can tell me what was the message in the video? It will be good if any student can answer this.
Write it in the check box.
Don't be shy, okay? In whatever language you want to speak, Hindi or English, you can just let me know your thought process.
One is coordination.
Okay, very fine.
Ragni Mishra. Neeru ma'am. Achha, Neeru ma'am. Yes. Participants can answer in chat box.
Yeah, actually, I am not able to see the chat box. So
just you click on.
I am sharing because I'm clicking on chat box.
The student can unmute yourself.
Yeah, please unmute yourself and we can have an interactive session here.
Yes, sir.
So anybody can tell me one thing I got that it was coordination. So video had shown two parts. One, how this racing car tire changing or this servicing was happening in 1950s, and then the another part was 2013 Melbourne. So one was coordination, we can say. Another thing, if you guys can think about.
Sir, one more thing is there, good coordination and better understanding between each other.
Yes, yes.
It's from Krishna, a student.
Very, very good, Krishna. Anything, let me guide you. Anything about timing? Do you remember the timing in the first phase of the video? That video in black and white in 1950s, and then it was red color.
One more is there, Elevation of Technology by Samit Tyagi, a student.
Okay. So might be you had not concentrated on the timing. In the first part, when 1950, the video shown that the whole process was done in 67 seconds. And the second part, when this was 2013, I think it was hardly 3 seconds. Hope you people has realized that. Fine. So the same thing is happening now in computer's domain. Previously, projects were there, which were executing in older techniques. Okay, let me share my screen. Okay, I will start with second slide. Although I was thinking that I will go with first slide first, then I'm starting with the model, software development models. I hope you people might have gone through if the subject has been covered in your course or in your year, first year or second year or third year. So we used to follow these models. You can see on the left hand side and the middle one, the waterfall model, a spiral model, V-shaped model, and prototype model. Actually, E is hidden by this picture. So it is prototype model. Okay. So in older days, what was happening that we used to take more time in executing and delivering the projects. So now in previous two talks, you saw that IT is changing very fast. Requirements or demands of customers are also very changing fast. So the same thing applied to the service providers, okay? So we need to develop our solutions. I think this E is hiding. No issue. Fine. So this slide I was showing to all of you. So you might have studied about these models, waterfall model, spiral model, V-shaped model, and prototype model. These all are techniques, older techniques or models which we use in software development. Waterfall is the most popular. Nowadays, there are new software development models or frameworks are coming in picture, like agile models and DevOps. Okay. So when you go to software industry, there are two parts of any software life cycle. One is the development, and second part is maintenance, okay, and which is known as operations or ops. Okay, so nowadays people are thinking that we should have a single team who is managing development and operations. Previously, what used to be there, that there used to be separate development teams were working, and then once software is created or built, then it was handed over to operations teams. Okay. Very similar to like when you are using your mobile phone and you have an issue, you used to call the customer care. So these customer care teams are basically these operations teams. So there are different level of teams. Like the first team will listen to your problem. Then they will say that, okay, we will come back to you. And there are different levels who will be solving your issues. Hope you are able to find. So my topic, I'm going back now. I'm talking on the project management technique, that is agile way. Okay, let me show you a little bit about some facts which I had collected from various resources. So PMI is a resource which primarily works in project management domain, and as per their data, nowadays roughly 71% organizations are using agile, you can say sometime, often or always. Okay, because agile is a new norm for developing projects or software development work, you can say. Next is from McKinsey. This I had a line with our today's topic, that post COVID-19, how things are changing. So as per their data, they are saying that 93% business units that had fully adopted the agile model before COVID-19 had outperformed, which was not earlier. Okay, or even the teams who had not adopted agile way of working. Fine. We had seen that the first speaker has talked about the computation power. Nowadays, people don't want to invest much in premises. Premises means company-owned hardwares and softwares, or you better say infrastructure. So now everybody is going on cloud, because cloud is giving you better facility. Like you can just rent whatever you want. You want someday 100 machines, you can rent 100 machines. Someday you don't want 100, you want only say 30 or 40, you can rent only 30 and 40. So these are changing very, very rapidly. And this kind of renting facilities there from various cloud providers like Amazon or Microsoft or Google, they all are the big players. Okay. And particularly in manufacturing domain also, roughly 27% organization totally depend on agile way of working, whereas roughly 50-55% companies are working on hybrid, like they are using traditional way of working and agile way of working. Okay, so let me go to the next level. Although we had seen certain examples, I had not quoted all. The major comparison when it comes to the new ways of working, we always compare with waterfall. Okay, so I had put here certain comparison. So if we see here, agile way of execution is more successful. In waterfall, it was 26%, whereas in agile, it was 42. Challenges are more in waterfall, whereas failing ratios also more in waterfall. Fine. If we talk about large projects and medium projects and small projects, then also we can see that agile is performing better than waterfall. Students, if you have, or faculty members, if you have any query, you can ask me in between also. Okay. As I had called out, let us make it an interactive session. Now here we are presenting certain statistics that why this agile is very popular. So I had quoted here certain parameters, starting with the accelerated software delivery. So the video which we saw initially, that similar thing is happening in software development world also. Clients are looking for faster delivery. They don't want to wait for 6 months or 6 months or 1 year. They are looking for delivery in weekly basis or bi-weekly basis, like that. So older ways of working will not be useful. Okay, so this is one of the primary reason. In waterfall, one of the main reason or one of the main constraint was there, that we cannot change the requirement. Fine, in waterfall, what happens, that we go from step to step. Like initially we go for requirement analysis, then design, then coding, then testing, and then deployment and maintenance. So there was gates. So you cannot go back to the previous gate in case. With the so fast changing technology, somebody has started developing a product, and the life cycle of this development was a 6 month, but after 4 months, something new came. Now client cannot say to the service provider that I want to change the technology, because there was a contract between the service provider, I mean to say the company who is developing the software, and the client or customer. So managing these changing priorities also causes a big reason to not use waterfall. Okay. Then I will not go for all of these parameters. I will just read out once. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. So like productivity got increased. Okay. Better alignment with the business. You will see that how better alignment is coming in agile way of working. The quality of software is increased. Then delivery predictability means when we will be able to deliver the projects. It was very commonly occurring scenario in waterfall ways of working. Like we were thinking that software will be delivered in 6 months, but because of poor quality, because of unclear requirements, not having proper communication with the client or business, it was not able to complete in 6 months. Okay. Risk was higher, which is reduced in agile way of working. Fine. Improve project visibility means what is going on in the project. Okay. Team morale is also very high. Cost is also reduced. Okay. Engineering practices are also improved. Okay. Nowadays, when we talk about software development domain, it is not people only sitting in India. We had seen most of the situations where teams are sitting in multiple places. Like India is a big hub, definitely, from the coding perspective, from the execution perspective, but we are looking for the people wherever the business is there. So for example, a client is there whose business is spread across 3 countries or 4 countries. In all those 4 countries, some of the people will be sitting over there from the same project. So teams are distributed, which is better managed in agile. Okay. And software maintainability also increased in agile way of execution. Before we go further, there is a very basic question comes that can we apply this agile way of working everywhere? So this is a framework which is known as Kinefin framework, which divides the software development work into 4 categories. One is simple, then another is complicated, then complex, and fourth is chaotic. Okay. In an easier way, if I talk about like how much is known and how much is unknown. Fine. So the first one, if I talk about simple, where we are very much sure about our requirement. Means almost 100% of the requirements are clear. In this situation, we will still go for waterfall, but getting 100% requirement in advance is now a very impractical situation because of changing requirements and changing technology and the expectation from the clients. These are very, very fast changing scenarios. Second is where requirements are visible, they are not changing. okay, then it will come into complicated. Third one is where your requirements are changing with time, particularly like in software development or in research area. This is complex domain. And the last one where nothing is clear, this is chaotic. So this third domain where this is complex scenario, where most of the projects are falling, we will apply agile, okay? Agile ways of working. So this is the agile word. When this agile word has, or agile ways of working is started in software development. So this agile way of working was started very long back, somewhere in 1950s. Some people might have heard about lean way of working, okay, which was developed by Toyota car manufacturing. Okay, they had created their own way of working, which was mainly focusing on reducing wastage. Okay, so as much wastage we can remove from the process so that productivity can be improved. Okay, it's a factory model kind of thing, whereas in softwares it was more on waterfall. And what happens usually in waterfall, that if a project is happening in, we estimated that project will be delivered in 6 months. So initially 3 to 3.5 months to 4 months, people are working in very, very slow pace. In last 2 months, they will all wake up and then there'll be a rush. So there is no sustainable development was there. People were taking very, very lightly the work initially. Okay. And then towards the end of the time frame, everybody was rushing. So it was impacting the quality of the work very badly. Okay. So there were around some 17 people who gathered together in 2001, and they had created a agile manifesto. Okay. And 12 agile principles, particularly for software development. Okay. And then certain frameworks came up, which were satisfying agile ways of working. Okay. Certain highlights you can see here. Agile manifesto was there. Okay. In waterfall way of working, usually it is a hierarchical team. Like there is a project manager. Under project manager, there will be 2 or 3 leads will be there, technology leads. Under technology leads, there will be technical analyst will be there, then senior software engineer, then software engineers, and there is a proper hierarchy is there, okay? But in agile way of working, we don't follow hierarchy, okay? In waterfall, we don't entertain changing requirements, where in agile, we are welcoming the changes, okay? In waterfall, we were delivering softwares after completing it 100%, okay? Like after 3 months or 6 months or 1 year or 2 years. Whereas in agile, we are delivering very, very frequently, like 2 weeks or 3 weeks or maximum 4 weeks, okay? We prefer face-to-face communication in this. And it is working on emergent ways of working, means you try, work, and then adjust. So you can see on the left-hand side, it is reflect, tune, and adjust. Okay. We should have meetings almost every day, not very long, very small meetings, like 15 minutes meeting. Okay. So I will do a much more deep dive into all these things. So you can see here, I had put here 2 things, Agile Manifesto and Agile Principles. So there were four values which are presented here, which are distributed. These 4 values are distributed in these 12 principles. Fine. In traditional methods, the importance was given to process and tools, whereas in Agile, it is more individual and interactions. Okay. Because process and tools are just means, okay? In Agile, more respect is given to people and the interaction. In waterfall, people were more running towards documentation, comprehensive documentation, like end-to-end documentation, whereas in Agile, document is there, but it is more focusing on a working software, which is the second one. Fine. Third is customer collaboration versus contract negotiation. In older ways, we used to interact with the client only on milestones, like a milestone is done in two months or 3 months. We will go there. Okay, we had agreed that I will be delivering this thing in 3 months. Please release your money that we had completed this. We were not much involving customer in the software development process. But in Agile way, we are putting a proper role in the software development process so that customer will always validate that how the work is going on. If they want to make any changes, they can make the changes. Okay. And the last one, responding to the change. If client is asking for certain change, we will be able to accommodate those change instead of just saying to the client that, no, I will not change this because this was the plan we had made at the start of the project. Fine. So these are manifestos. I will not take principles in detail. You can just Google it out. If you want to learn about these principles, you just write Agile principle. These are 12 in numbers. Fine. Next is, now we talk about various frameworks. Okay. So Agile is basically a concept. It's an umbrella. And under this umbrella, we have various frameworks or models which are practiced by various organizations. Okay. So we have Scrum, Kanban, Lean, Crystal, fine. BDD, that is known as behavior-driven development. TDD, that is test-driven development. Then feature-driven development and so on. Okay. This I had taken from State of Agile report. This has given a big picture that which framework is used primarily by the organizations. So Scrum is a framework which has been used by the company maximum. It is 58%. Then 10% companies are using a combination of a framework, which is Kanban, which you can see here, 7%. So there is a combination of Scrum and Kanban known as Scrumban, that is 10%. Then hybrid means multiple technologies, like they are using Scrum, Kanban, or say Lean, or say extreme programming, that is hybrid. Okay. So this is 9%, or even waterfall also sometimes they use. And then rest you can see Lean or iterative development. So these are the various frameworks which we are using in Agile way of execution. So I had selected two frameworks to discuss with you. Fine. The first framework which I want to discuss with you people is Scrum framework. Okay. In a waterfall model, we used to have various roles, okay, like project manager, technology leads, then developer roles are there, then we have tester roles, then we have business analysts, we have infrastructure management people who used to manage the infrastructure, means hardware, software, network, and all those things. So the model was having many roles and different levels. Okay. Whereas in Scrum, there are only three players has been defined. Who are the three players? Product owner, the development team, and Scrum Master. Only three players. The fourth player is basically rest of all, means product owner, team, Scrum Master, and rest of all, which is stakeholders or from both sides, from the service provider, you mean to say the company for which you are working, and the customer for whom you are developing the software. Okay, stakeholders from both the sides. So how it starts? It used to take the requirements from executives, stakeholder, business users, and all. So product owner is basically somebody from business who will be consistently working with this team. Fine, which was not the case in other software development techniques. Okay, we used to meet business once in a while, where in this Scrum framework, business, which will be represented by product owner, will be part of the team. Okay, and it will be the product owner who will be creating the requirements, which is known, which is technically known as product backlog. Means there are requirements, like here you can see some representative requirements are made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. And in waterfall, we were working for 3 to 6 months to 1 year. Here also the case will be similar, that project may be delivered in 3 months to 6 months or 1 year, but we will not be delivering at the end of the project, whereas we will be delivering this in small cycles, which are known as sprints. And what can be the sprint size? It is 1 to 4 weeks. Like this one, you can see 1 to 4 weeks. Usually in software development industry, 2 weeks is the most popular sprint cycle. Means we will take requirements in such a way that we will be able to deliver those requirements. Means we will be able to create the design, we will be able to create the coding, we will be able to do the testing, minimum unit testing, and if feasible, we can do system integration testing and deployment also. Okay, depending on domain, it may go for 1 to 4 weeks. 1 week is very, very less practiced, because it is very small time, and in 1 week doing all these things is quite hectic in nature. These are known as hyper sprints. Okay, so 2 weeks, 3 weeks, and 4 weeks are popular. Maximum projects are using 2 weeks, roughly say 70%. 3 weeks around, you can say more 25%, and rest in 5%, we can think about 1 week or 4 week of a sprint. Okay. So what happens that when a sprint starts, we will pick the work which we want to deliver, but with the coordination of this product owner and team and Scrum Master, who is the person who will be doing the balance between these two. Okay. They will do this work, and towards the end of the sprint, say suppose we had started on day one on say Monday, and the next week's Friday we will be delivering the work. Okay, so there is a event known as a sprint review or demo, where the team will be demonstrating the work to the client or the stakeholders. Okay, and on the same day they will again sit together and they will see that where they can improve. So they ask questions like what has been done well, what has not been done well, what we can stop, we will not practice this way of working, what we can add up new ways. Okay, and every day they used to meet for 15 minutes, which is known as daily scrum. Fine, usually in the morning session of the day. Another framework which we want to we can discuss, that is Kanban framework, which is the previous one is a little bit technical, but this framework we can certainly practice in our day-to-day life, which I can say that whether you are a faculty member or you are a student, you can definitely practice this. Okay, so this is a backlog, means where you are listing down the work, like a student can list their work. Okay, there are 6 subjects in my current semester, and from which subject these are the lessons or say chapters or the practical work which I need to complete. And you can make a priority. The highest priority work will be on top, and then you'll be selecting that out of these say 10 work which a student want to do, he will or she will select certain, and then from these selection they will be go into processing, means you will work on that, and then finally you can move the work into done. Okay, so this is a Kanban, very very light framework, which is mostly used in manufacturing or service domain. The people who are owning any bike or car, if you go to service center, this Kanban board, it is known as a Kanban board. This word is a Japanese word, Kanban, which means visualize. Okay, so this board is still much in use in current service stations primarily. Okay, or in when you join a company, you will see that certain projects are using this board in their software development process or maintenance process. Till now, it was more of theoretical, and I had left with only 7 minutes. So I will try to make it a little bit fast. This particular slide I had made for students. You can note it down in case if you want. These all are practices which are used by all software development service providing companies. Okay. So these practices are much done and better done in agile way of working. So unit testing is testing which is done by the individual coder or software developer. Okay. We used to have coding standard. It is not like in a simple way, like when we are in school and colleges, we make programs, say, for example, make a program to add two numbers. What we write, integer I, comma j, fine. But this is not the way. When we are working in companies, we used to follow certain coding standards, like the name of the variable will be like this, where we can use iteration loops, which kind of loop, where it is while or do while, okay, or for loop. You need to follow certain coding standards. Okay. Then test-driven development. In traditional way, what happens that our development team or software development team are divided into 3-4 categories of groups. One is development team, one is testing team, one is business experts, one is infrastructure team. I had already named these teams. So what happens that usually requirement comes and then developed by the developer, and then it goes to tester. Whereas in this test-driven development, what happens that first all the tests are done and then all tests are made to fail. Okay. And then these tests are given, test cases are given to the development team, and then they will write a code in such a way that all the tests will pass, and then we will say that our development is over. Okay, so this is known as test-driven development. It is very, very popular programming practice nowadays. Okay, then we can talk about continuous deployment. Now, I had shown you one practice that is known as DevOps, which is automating the software development process. So previously what used to be there, once the project is delivered, then there will be a team who will be deploying the software or the product to the client machine or environment. Usually it used to be done on Saturdays or Sundays, but and it was taking the business system down. Okay. So it was not good for business or the customer. So nowadays, what is happening that we are adopting techniques where continuous deployment is feasible using automations, okay, which is known as CICD, continuous integration and continuous deployment. There is a concept known as pair programming, which has been taken from one agile methodology known as extreme programming. Instead of one person, there'll be two people who will be working on same code. Okay, so it can be managed better. Okay, similar to test-driven development, another one is behavior-driven development. The requirements will be written in such a way that it will It will satisfy certain behavior of the client need. Okay. Then sustainable pace, I had already talked about that in older ways, pace was not sustainable. In initial days of the project life cycle, people were doing rest and enjoyment, and towards the end of the days, they were all working and overheading themselves. Whereas in this case, in Agile, we need to deliver some piece of requirement, workable piece of requirement in each 2 weeks of time. So it is not like initially we will take rest and towards the end of the project life cycle time, we all will work and overhead ourselves. Like initially we work only for say 2-3 hours, rest of the day better enjoy yourself, and towards the end of the software development life cycle, we are working for 15 days or 15 hours or 20 hours. Okay. So sustainable pace is there. This agile way of working does not freeze the design. Design can be changed because requirements are also changed, and we are welcoming the requirements, requirement change. Okay. Code will not be only owned by the single developer. It will be owned by the team. Okay. Continuous integration, I had already told here with this. Refactoring the code happens when we want to increase the quality of the code, like code tuning. I hope Gagan sir must have taught you about code tuning. He used to do a lot when we were working together in College of Engineering Roorkee. Okay. So code tuning gives you the feature of enhancing the productivity of the code. Okay. And then finally, the automated acceptance testing, which will be done by the client. I am left with only 1 minute. So this is the last slide, I hope. So I will take it in a faster way. These are certain challenges. Okay. General organization resistance to change. Okay. What is this resistance? Look, nobody wants to change themselves. It's a very true fact. Okay. It is a law of inertia. When a thing or an object is in motion, the object don't want to stop. And if any object is sitting idle, it doesn't want to be in motion. Okay. The physics law. Same thing is working in humans' nature also. In older techniques, it was different way of working. And now in this agile way of working, you have to be on toes. You need to face the client after every 15 days. Okay. So that change people used to reflect. The culture is still, we are living in the world where people dictates. Okay. Your project manager will run behind you, run behind the lead will run behind the analyst, analyst will run behind the software engineer, and so on. But in Agile, nobody will run behind anybody. It's a flat team. The team is, as a whole team, people are responsible to deliver the software or the product. Okay. If people doesn't have in proper skills, then it will maybe result into a tough situation when we will not be able to deliver this. Okay. We need to properly evolve the processes. Okay. It also needs a proper tooling. The old tools are not much helpful. Okay. There are new tools like Jira or version one, project management tools. Okay. If business is not available, you can recall the product owner role. So business has to be there all the time with the team, not say full day, but at least for 1 hour, 2 hour every day. So in case if team is requiring certain answers, business should be able to give it. And this adoption of Agile usually percolate from leadership. If leadership is not participating in this, then also it is very tough to implement. Okay. If we are not able to share our knowledge, we are not able to collaborate properly, then also there will be issues. And if people are still saying, no, like in certain TV programs, we say that our days were very good. Okay. In my days, this was happening. Now this generation is something like this. It is not the correct way, correct statement. Every time things, like we say that change is the only constant. Okay, things are changing, technologies are changing, so we need to evolve ourselves also with respect to these changes. If we are still keeping our old mindset, and because of your boss is pushing to you, you are just adopting it, then you will not be successful. Okay, so these are certain challenges we have. So I think I had ended my presentation almost within time, 3 minutes over. So if any questions are there, I'll be very happy to take it.
Yes, students, if you have any query, then write on the chat box.
Yeah, I'm able to see the chat box. I had tried my best so that a student can be benefited from this discussion.